sort of the external influences. And we've had some influence from the Russian Mennonites, then John Martin becoming Christian. Now, what outside support nurture did you have then in your faith?
Henry Jensen, who was the pastor of the Russian Mennonite group on Kitchen. He had Bible study in Israel and Jacinda.
Okay, so that was a strong support to you.
Yeah. And he was an occasional speaker at the Nathan Martin's house down there.
Okay. And that all sort of happened in the same year or the same year.
And then in my case, at least, I don't know how much in your case, but Simeon Martin.
Yes.
Yeah. Simeon Martin was a great, support and leader.
He was attending the St. Jacob's Mennonite Church. Yeah. And they were already built. Because there was this strong evangelist. Were they quite evangelistic?
At that time, yeah.
Much for years prior to that, eh? Yeah.
Yes. I don't remember them.
But they didn't really have an influence on you people. Like the Fries and the Metzgers. When did they become?
When I got saved, I began to witness to Ezra. He was my age, and he was very sympathetic. And his girlfriend quit on him, and he was terribly downhearted. And at that time, I used to witness to him about being saved. And he got saved at that time.
His
girlfriend died.
She
left him.
She also had. He also did have a girlfriend that died.
I thought so. I didn't remember.
Yes.
Okay.
They did.
Yes. She died. John's girlfriend left him before he got saved.
Okay. John.
Did they live close to you? The Red Fries?
No.
But you had contact with them because they were your cousins?
Well, they were going to the same Comstock Mennonite Church.
Okay.
And first cousin.
In my case, there was one of the more or less disturbing things that went on. John Martin was blessed to be saved, and this was quite a stir in the community. So Henry Martin had been what you maybe could say a silent saint. He had been saved through Simeon Martin, but was quite quiet about it.
This was the Henry Hoffman. And he was working as a hired man.
And then he went to visit John Martin. And when he came back, he was just bubbling over with this, and singing hallelujahs, about it. He was rejoicing in this ambition, and I tried to tell Henry Martin that he'd better put the brakes on. He's going off the deep end. He's going to go crazy if this keeps on. Well, he said, look, it's the Word of God. And no, in no way. This is contrary to the Bible. Well, show me where it's contrary. So I started reading the Word. I'd come across John 3:16, that's just up his alley, that's just what he likes. No, I can't use that. John 5:24, another one that I can't use. Acts 4:12, one after the other. And those that I thought I could use, I brought to him, and then he'd explain them contrary to what I thought that they meant. Maybe he's right. Eventually, I came to the conclusion that I have to admit, he knows more what he stands for than I do.
And so then, how long was it, Sydney, from the time that you think you became a believer? You're not quite sure, in the 32 or 33?
I think it was 32.
And then how long was it till you went off up north with the...
It was was in the spring of 35.
35. So you were around 3 years around home and working on the farm, basically. Not quite a time. Okay.
Do you remember how much encouragement I gave you to go up north?
My sister Katie, maybe she was the only one. Had faith in me. No one even. I told Anias Weaver one time, he, with his friendly chuckle, he said, well, that's something you know. But I'm not surprised. I'm not really surprised that people felt that way, because I was not a talker. I was not educated. There was nothing in my favor. John Martin, he could hold a congregation for 20 minutes, good listening, and I'd be up 5 minutes, and that was all. And but there was something in which I could do better than John. When we were back in the home, I could relax the family, and I could go walk in the kitchen and talk to the cook and lead a conversation. I was just perfectly at ease. And John wasn't quite that relaxed. He was not the pastor. He was the teacher. And I was the pastor. When I look back, I wouldn't have known at that time. But now that I look back, the difference between the gifts.